Cleaning out the rain gutters is never fun, but in this story written by Gorilla of Undeath, we learn that sometimes cleaning the gutters could lead to a chance encounter with the gutter monkey.
Nag, nag, nag. That is all my wife does anymore. I'm sitting there trying to enjoy the football game, and she's screaming up a storm about how the gutters need to be cleaned. How they are making the place stink, or whatever baloney she can make up to annoy me. After weeks of her pestering me, I finally had enough of the constant nagging, so I did what any guy would do, and finally caved in and went to the garage to get the ladder. I tried to carefully carry the ladder out from my garage, but I cursed loudly as I bumped it into the edge of the wall. I leaned the ladder up against the side of my house and stopped to look up. I didn't much like heights, but the gutters needed to be cleaned, that was for sure. I hesitated for a moment, trying to think of another way to get the job done. But in the end, I figured the best way to do it right is to get up there and get my hands dirty. I climbed the ladder with deliberate care, and as I reached the gutters, I could see that my wife was right. The gutters were clogged with smelly leaves and stagnant water that reeked. I started pulling the wet leaves out and throwing them down into a bucket. The stench was absolutely horrid, like something had died up there. As I continued to remove leaves, something shiny caught my eye. It was a sparkling coin, just resting in the gutter under some of the leaves. I picked the thing up and eyed it curiously. The coin was golden and etched with the face of a monkey on one side, while the other side was etched with a scimitar. It was definitely a strange coin. A high-pitched voice broke the silence. Startling me, I nearly fell off the ladder.
"Ah, you found my coin,"
the voice said. I turned my head, and down at the end of the gutter was a small black monkey about the size of a chipmunk. His fur was matted and dirty, slicked with wet gutter water and bits of leaves. His red eyes lit up as he gave me a devilish little smile. "What the hell are you?" I asked.
"Oh, me? Well, I'm the gutter monkey, of course. You've got my coin now. Why not try it out?"
"What does it do?" I asked.
"Flip the coin. You get the side with my face, you'll get good fortune. You get the side with the scimitar, and you'll get bad fortune. It's so simple, really. Try it out."
I hesitated for a moment, looking down again at the golden coin. I honestly didn't give it much more thought than that as I placed it on my thumb and flicked it into the air. I caught the coin in the palm of my hand and looked down to see that the scimitar side was facing up.
"Oh, that's just too bad,"
the gutter monkey said. I had barely registered the words, "too bad," when a second later I felt my ladder tipping back and gravity taking me. I woke up in the hospital feeling hazy and out of it. The doctors told me I hit my head hard, and they were worried I wouldn't wake up. Said it was a miracle I actually woke up so soon. They told me there might be some long-term repercussions from the head injury, such as frequent migraines, but they could manage it. They told me they wanted to keep me for further monitoring. I expected to see my wife by my bedside, but she didn't even bother to show up. I figured I was only good to her as her little workhorse, and this all but proved it. I turned on the TV when the doctors left, but as I looked over at the window, I saw something small and black peek its head out from behind the curtains. I recognized those red eyes. It was the gutter monkey. The stench of stagnant water and leaves wafted into my nose. The gutter monkey stared at me for a moment, then pulled that same golden coin out from behind his back and tossed it to me. It landed on my lap and bed.
"Give it another try. This time, maybe you'll get some good fortune.
I thought a little harder this time on whether it was worth it. But in the end, I did it again. And this time, it landed on the monkey's face. I let out a relieved sigh and smiled. I'll finally get some good fortune, I thought to myself.
Looks like you win. Good fortune for you,
the gutter monkey said, and then he disappeared in a cloud of smoke, taking the coin with him. I waited and waited for my good fortune. Hours had passed when two police officers entered my room. One hung back and the other came and introduced himself to me. He was formal, but not exactly friendly. The officer pulled up a chair alongside my bed.
Really sorry to bother you after your injury, but I'm afraid we have some bad news, the officer said.
He took a deep breath before he spoke again. A few hours ago, we found your wife dead in your home. Appears someone broke in and murdered her.